question on the topic.
Thank you so much. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. My name is Muhammad Khairul Bashar. I come from Riau. I am a university student focused on Islamic education. My question is, what is the right of commentary, or what is the right understanding for Surat Al-Ma'idah, chapter number 5, verse number 51, that is, Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu, latattakhidhul yahuda wan nasara awliya. What is the right of understanding for our awliya for this verse? Thank you so much.
The brother has asked a question which comes in every question answer session in Indonesia from the time I'm here. What is the understanding of the verse of the Quran of Surah Maidah, chapter 5, verse number 51? Allah says in the Quran in Surah Maidah, chapter number 5, verse number 81, that let not the believers, Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu, O you believe, take not for awliyas, awliyas are a big word, which means friend, helper, protector, the Jews or the Christian. Do not take for awliya the Jew or a Christian, Yahud or Nasara, because they are awliya unto themselves. Means they are friends, protectors and supporters to themselves. Anyone who does this is in the wrong. This verse is very explicit and very clear that Allah is telling the Muslims. This verse doesn't specifically refer only to leaders. Most of the people think it's only talking about elections. It's not talking about, it can include, it does include, not can, does include. It's talking general, that as for taking awliya, awliya is the Arabic word which means friend, protector or helper. If you want to take any protector or helper, don't take the Yahud and Nasara. They are Yahud and Nasara, are awliya among themselves. If you do, you will become one of them. But if you take them as your protector, you become one of them. Now this verse is not as famous as the other verses of the Quran. The best commentary of the Quran is the Quran itself. Then comes the authentic hadith. Allah says in Surah Imran chapter 3 verse number 28, let not the believers take for awliya, take for friends, helpers or protectors, unbelievers, mushrik, in preference to the believers. Don't take for helpers, protectors and friends, non-Muslims, in preference to Muslim. Anyone who does this, Allah's help will not come to you, except by way of warning. That means if you choose, if you have a choice between a Muslim and non-Muslim, for an awliya, for a friend, for a protector, for a leader, do not take the non-Muslim rather than the Muslim. If you do that, Allah's help will not be with you, except by way of warning. Allah repeats the message in Surah Nisa, chapter 4, verse number 144, several places. Allah says, let not the believers take for awliya, a friend, a protector, a helper, an unbeliever in preference to a believer, a non-Muslim in preference to a Muslim. Anyone who have done, the wrath of Allah will be there. It is very clear cut. Let me tell you, this verse of the Quran is not specifically talking about leaders. It is talking about general. Leaders are included. And if you read the teachings of Ibn Hanbal, may Allah have mercy on him, he said that Abu Musa al-Ash'ari, may Allah be pleased with him, one of the Sahaba, he approached Hazrat Umar, may Allah be pleased with him, the second caliph of Islam, and told him, I have a Christian as my scribe. Scribe, the one who writes. Some of the translations say as an accountant. Accountant. He told Abu Musa al-Ash'ari, may Allah be pleased with him, one of the Sahabas, tells to the second caliph of Islam, Hazrat Umar, may Allah be pleased with him, I have a Christian as one of my scribes. So Hazrat Umar, may Allah be pleased with him, he replies, that what is wrong with you? May Allah bring death on you. How can you take a Christian as a scribe? Don't you know what Allah has said? And he recites the verse of Surah Maidah, chapter 5, verse number 51. Hazrat Umar, may Allah be pleased with him. Ya alladhina amanu, O you believe, take not for awliya the Jews and the Christian. They are awliya among themselves. And if you do that, you will become one of them. He said, don't you have a Hanif? Don't you have a Muslim? Abu Musa al-Ash'ari, may Allah be pleased with him, replies, Ya Amirul Mu'mineen, he is very beneficial to me and he keeps to his faith. The Sahaba replies to Hazrat Umar al-Mu'mineen, Amirul Mu'mineen, that he is very useful for me. That means he knows the accounts very well. Another saying says, there is no one better than him. And he keeps to his faith. That means he is not interfering with us. Hazrat Umar, may Allah be pleased with him, he replies, that when Allah has humiliated them, I will never honor them. When Allah has humiliated the Christians, I will never honor them. This is the second caliph of Islam. Leave aside a leader. I know this question is asked. I'm wondering why is everyone asking this question. Then I came to know that there is an election now in Jakarta for the governorship. One Christian and one Muslim is standing. I don't know any of them. Here, Hazrat Umar, may Allah be pleased with him, tells, you cannot keep an accountant. Leave aside governor. Governor is very big. He objects to Abu Musa al-Ash'ari, may Allah be pleased with him, and he tells him to remove him. He says, may Allah bring death to you. Imagine, Amirul Mu'mineen, Hazrat Umar, radiallahu an, he is telling, what is wrong with you? May Allah bring death on you. Strong words. Narrated by Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal. To appoint an accountant, and the Muslims of Indonesia want to appoint a governor. I was there in Bandung, and one lady, again, deviated Muslim, born in Muslim family, proud to be an atheist, says, but that Christian is more beneficial. I said, what benefit? He removes poverty. He's getting more benefit. Maybe he's giving more money. Maybe. Someone told me they give money for you to vote. I tell there are three conditions. I don't know both of them. But I know for sure, one is a Muslim, one is a Christian. There can be three conditions. Maybe the Muslim is better than the Christian. Maybe both are same. Maybe Christian is better than the Muslim. In the first case, if Muslim is better than the Christian, you have to vote for the Muslim. There is no logic in not voting for him. If both are equal, Allah is very clear cut that in preference to an unbeliever, in preference to a believer, you cannot take an unbeliever, you cannot take Jew or Christian as your awliya. If I agree hypothetically that the Christian is 10 times better than the Muslim, I'm not saying he's better, hypothetically, I don't know both of them. Allah is very clear in it that if you take an unbeliever as your awliya in preference to a believer, Allah's help will not come to you. If I agree that the Christian is 100 times better, maybe if you vote him, you will get 1 million rupees, 10 million rupees every month, possible. If you vote the Muslim, you may lose 10 million rupees every month, possible. Yet, I would vote for the Muslim. You know why? Allah's support will be with you. If I vote for the Christian, maybe I will get 10 million rupees every month benefit. He may do something for me. Or 100 million benefit. But Allah's help will not come to you. Now choice is yours. Do you want Allah's help? Do the Muslims of Indonesia want Allah's help?
Yes. Yes.
I think Muslims don't require Allah's help. All of them are self-sufficient. Allah says in the Quran, in Surah Imran chapter 3 verse 160, if Allah helps you, none can overcome you. If Allah forsakes you, who is there then who can help you? So let the believers put their trust in Allah. In this case, there is no two opinion at all. I normally don't involve in politics. I'm not a politician. Islam, there is politics in Islam, but where country where I come from, India, politics is dirty. Islam is a complete way of life. There is no two doubts at all that the verse of the Quran, not one, many verses. Surah Maida chapter 5 verse number 80, I can quote many verses. There is no two doubt at all. Any Muslim who has the basic knowledge of the Quran and knows the tafsir of the Quran, even in his dream, he cannot say, elect a non-Muslim. He cannot say. There are various tafasir. There are various translations. All the Aimmas, all the Sahabas, the Khulafa Rashideen. There is no two doubts. There's a brother, a Hindu brother in Bandung, who came and told me, Brother Zakir, but if that Christian is benefiting me and he's a good human being, so what is wrong in voting for him? I gave the same example which I gave to the sister earlier. I told him, if you have an employee who you are paying 100 million rupees every month, he does not come to office. He is going and working for somebody else. You tell him, okay, you have to come every day to my office. I am paying you 100 million rupees and you have to do so and so work. And when you go back home, you help the others. What he's doing? He is not following your main criteria. He's not coming to office only. He's going to somebody else's office. And from that 100 million rupees, he is giving 1 million rupees every month in charity. Giving charity is good. He's taking from you, not coming to your office. I told him at the end of the month, he comes only once to your office to take money, salary. What will you do? Will you give him bonus? He said, no. What will you do? You'll kick him out. I said, why? He's giving 1 million rupees to poor people. And he's taking your 100 million and not following your commandment. He's doing shirk. He's going and working for somebody else. You are paying him the money. Almighty Allah has given you this life, has given you the wealth, has given you this body. Everything belongs to him. You go and worship somebody else. And you have another employee who follows everything but does not help others, but comes to office correctly. He comes exactly 8 o'clock, goes at 6 o'clock, follows all your commandment, but does not give 1 million rupees from my salary. Who will you appreciate? He said, the second one. So even if the Muslim doesn't benefit you, but because he has iman in Allah, because your success in this world is iman. Your success in this world is not rupees, it's not wealth, it is not luxury, it is not house, it is not car, it is not position, it is iman. Many of us think that if this one comes to power, I'll get a better house, I'll make more money. So many people think wealth is success. According to Surah Al-Asr, chapter number 103, verse number 1-3, wal as inna al-insana lafi khusr illa alladhina amanu wa amilu salihati wa tawasaw bil haqq wa tawasaw bis sabr. By the token of time, man is verily in a state of loss except those who have iman, those who have faith. those who have righteous deed, those who exhort people to truth, to dawah, and those who exhort people to patience and perseverance. So according to Surah Maida chapter 5 verse number 51, according to Surah Imran chapter 3 verse number 28, according to Surah Nisa chapter 4 verse 144, according to Surah Maida chapter 5 verse number 80, and many hadith and many sayings of the scholars, of the tafaseers, if there is a choice in selecting an awliya, a friend, a protector or a helper, it is a believer. You know, in my organization in India, we have 500 employees. 500. How many?
500.
500 paid employees. In a country which is a minority country, in a country where Muslims are minority, 100% all our employees are Muslims. I'm not telling you keeping non-Muslim employees haram. I'm not telling you that. Don't get me wrong. Allah clearly states in Surah Mumtahina, chapter number 60, verse number 8. Allah forbids you not from being unjust to the unbelievers who drive you not out of your home and fight you not to religion. Generally, you have to be kind to the non-Muslims. You have to help them. You have to support them. When required, even protect them. No problem. This is Islam. You can protect them. Don't make them your protectors. You can help them. Don't make them your supporters. This is the guidance of Allah. And in your offices, in my office in Bombay, it was compulsory. Every Muslim should pray 5 times Salah. In Jamaat, in the mosque, every day read the Quran at least for 20 minutes. It is my, you are my employee, follow my instructions. Why? Oh, 500 employees every time going for Salah 3 to 4 times in a day. During office hours, reading Quran every day, you're wasting 1 hour, multiply by 500 people, multiply by 30 days. Nuksan, loss, khasara. What khasara? Man is in khasara. We are doing for iman because I want Allah's help. Even though I know that there are many non-Muslims who are better in many things, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, choose the believer. So there is no two doubts at all. There is no two options at all. You have to select a Muslim. Hope that answers the question.
Thank you so much.